Lights, camera, traction.
This is Josh from Typo Negative, and I'm here to talk to you about what is important to me.
This is Megan Glenn Hickey, and she was born to me on January 6th, 1997. She's brand new, fresh melon. She was most unexpectedly conceived, what was it, 19 months ago, on the last night that I was home for a four-month tour. And she was the most incredible surprise that's ever come into my life. She is my reason for waking up every day. She takes three or four steps now to me, and she loves remotes. Favorite toy in the whole world. In fact, the most interesting thing she's ever done was we left her with her grandmother to babysit one night, and she loves to play with phones. So she picks up the cordless phone and dials 911 by accident and calls the police department. Sure enough, an hour later, the police show up at my mother's door, insisting on searching the whole house. And so they did. They searched the house plus her tenant before they figured out that it was Megan who called the cops on them. Bubby, Bubby, come on. Ah! Come on, Juju B. Come on, Juju B. I call her Juju B. Juju B, come. Come on. Yeah! Yay! Mwah. This is Mama, Bonnie Weiss, my lady of 10 years. Say hello, Mom.
Hi.
And this is our new apartment, which took us 2 weeks to prepare. We redid everything. We bought new furniture. We spent loads of stupid money, right? Although it doesn't look like much. And Meg is going to show you her room. Come on, let's go. Show me your room. Come on. That's this place. You know this place. Oh, as you can see, we did a lot of detailed work here. Stencils for different paint jars, and we hung up stickers. We did the Sesame Street theme. You like Sesame Street, right? Yeah? Mm-hmm. I could never, ever picture myself as a father. My whole life. Because I guess I never really liked myself that much, but I was terrified when I found out she was coming along. But I soon found out she was the easiest thing I've ever loved in my life. She's made me complete.
Say bye-bye. Come on, bye-bye.
She's gonna take a nap.
Hello, Ma.
That's great. Okay.
Megan, right?
Uh-huh.
Megan.
Megan. Hello.
Sit behind her.
Hey.
Maybe you can move your hand a little bit.
Good enough.
That's great. Mm.
I don't think it's any wonder why autumn is the most favorite season of just about everyone. But the trees are aflame and the water still. It is by far my favorite season. This is probably the perfect location, as you see here, for me to build my dream house, like a Frank Lloyd Wright type of falling water house in a location like this, but a lot more glass. And every morning when I wake up, I have the woods to one side and water to the other, the sky above, and it would always seem like I was outside and I could enjoy nature and all the seasons. So perhaps take a few trees down here, a very few trees, build a nice little house for my woman and worship her the rest of my life.
Out over at my friend Bruce Palladino's body shop on Limited Auto Body in Brooklyn. Bruce is the mayor of 63rd Street. Bruce hardly does any work. Every time you come by to see Bruce, he's always somewhere else. And the guys that work with him, you always come looking for Bruce, and he's always like, oh, he's over at this shop, he's always over at that shop.
But, not that bad.
Bruce is actually a distant relative of Earl Sharp. And Earl gave Bruce his start in the business.
Yeah.
Certainly isn't going to pass any white glove test. Bruce is one of the few guys that will actually take on a job working on a car like this. A lot of body shops don't want to get involved in something that has this much work. Basically, there really isn't a lot of money in it for a body shop. And it takes a lot of time and a lot of effort as opposed to doing a regular insurance job or something.
Which is true.
And we're certainly appreciative of guys like Bruce. Guys like me, we have a passion for stuff like this, and it's hard to find, you know, good guys to do good work and for a good price. I've had the motor longer than I've had the car. The car, when I bought it, had a 383 engine in it. I blew the timing chain, and I had this 440 sitting around. I figured just put this motor in. This motor's pretty clean. I take the car everywhere. I drove it to Atlantic City. I had to stop twice for gas. I was definitely born 20 years too late. All my tastes, they're all going back to, like, you know, the late 60s, early 70s. If I was my father's age, I definitely would have had a much better time.
It's something that I've always wanted to do since I was younger. When I was a kid, I used to see all these, you know, all the cars when they were, like, new, see them on the street, and, you know, see the older guys, like, you know, racing on the streets and, you know, watching TV, watching drag racing and stuff like that. Eventually, you know, I'd like to get the car into a state where I could actually take it to shows and, you know, have, you know, hopefully other people appreciate, you know, this time period of automotive engineering, you know. It's kind of like a functional art, you know, like a nice bridge.
These are some of the things both myself and the other hippies in my band dislike about festivals. The first and foremost is the lack of toilets at the locations to which we're assigned. If Vanessa would turn the camera towards my friend Josh, you will see that Josh cannot find a bathroom, and he is resorting to what comes naturally. What he will use for toilet paper is another mystery. I would advise viewers out there to not shake Josh's hand. Well, I think we've seen enough of Josh right now. Thank you, Josh. See that vertical smile? Great. Here we see some of the members of a Typo Negative with Mr. David Vincent. Now keep in mind, it is 8 o'clock in the morning here, and they're having beer for breakfast. Of course, beer for lunch, and beer for dinner. There's Kenny, or is that a urine sample? I'm not quite sure, but at this point, I don't think he knows the difference either.
The third thing we hate about festivals is the lack of drugs and inability to find any. We were just wondering where we can find some drugs. I figured if we got the police, you must have all the drugs locked up in the truck.
No. Nix. Nothing.
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 You have not confiscated any drugs from the fans?
Nope.
Nope. Thank you very much, then.
This is a rare exception that the food today was actually very good. I could identify the meat. It looks like it used to be chicken, perhaps a pig at one point. Not a mixed creature, but two separate ones. There's the barbecue. Yep. Pork chops. As you see, very, very clean silverware. Perhaps only used once or twice, only today. Ready?
The last and final problem of festivals is finding the band before the performance.
Now we are on our tour bus where we've been for the last week. And as you see by the height of the ceiling, it's not a comfortable situation for me. I believe that the bus was designed by people under 1 meter tall. So now I'm going to rest my ass on the seat because I've hit my head 17 times already this very day.
We are searching for Kenny in the woods.
I have my supply of vitamins here. That's usually pretty cool. Hold on a second. It's a lot of fun going through customs with this. And from time to time, you may get someone who actually pops one of these into their mouth to see if they're full of cocaine or heroin or some other shit like that, which, of course, they're not. They're just very expensive but legal chemicals.
Excuse me, brothers. Have you seen Kenny from Typo Negative?
No.
No, he has not been arrested or?
No.
Oh, so you must all be very safe and very careful. So, make sure you use these.
Excuse me, brother. Have you seen Kenny from Typo Negative?
How's that?
Have you seen Kenny from Typo Negative?
No, I haven't.
Okay, thank you, man.
All right.
The only other stuff I have left in here is deodorant and shampoo. Prozac. I'm not gonna show.
Excuse me, brother. Have you seen Kenny from Typo Negative?
No.
Excuse me, one more time, please. Thank you.
I think you've seen enough. If you want to take a walk and see the bongs, that's up to you. But they're smelly and dirty and dark and dank. So maybe we should just leave that to the imagination.
Kenny. It is time to play the show. Shall we go? There we go.
The original King Kong movie, what he said when he was standing on top of you. The wall, the
he
giant
said, donut.
He said, Onku Kantu Kong. He did.
And every one of Kong's footsteps, you hear the floor drum. That was a great shot. Yeah, it's on. It's on record.
That was really
you hit it right on the landing.
It's a close-up anyway.
Come on, I'll fix it. Fire you! Kong!
You're having too much fun over there by yourself.
That's all right, buddy. Come on, man. You're starting to make me count right now.
There he is, Keith Richards of the 90s.
Typo Negative will be coming to Europe, probably, assuming the flight actually makes it out of the airport. And there's no missile launches or anything pointed at it. And we hope to see you there, and we're going to be supporting October Rust.
You can say that again. What? Would you be supporting October Rust?
Anyway, yeah, we'll be in Europe.
October Rust.
What was that?
October Rust. It's the name of the new Typo Negative LP. Be my druidess.
Yo, Phil, fuck you
I
too.
I love
man.
It, goddammit. Why yo, am I yelled yo. At? Be my druidess and Bacchus and what forth?
Talking about the songs. It's the ladies that love it, goddammit.
Are you a lady?
No, but I love it too, though. Check it out.
I love you too, Phil.
I love you too, man.
Thank you.
See that? Everything's wonderful.
Hey, I think you need more kick drum before we go.
Scream when you're ready. He's got those headphones on again. Talking to his wife.
Alright, so I just fucked up the whole ending because I wasn't in the right bank because we did the song.
So we can't do the song five times, that's it.
Leave it as is. What are you gonna do, man? Every song five times?
Take 42.
Take 42.
Yeah.
I want to do it again. I'm dead serious, man. I want to do it again. Yeah.
Let's go.
I could have went right through.
She's in love with herself.
No.
She likes the dog.
Why'd you sing it?
All the milk my neck. Devil's mark. Now it's all how old is. Home is full. Or will she trick or treat? I'll bet she will.
I'm the vice president.
Oh, no. Wait. That's uncomfortable.
Of Blue Grape Merchandising. This is how we renegotiate the typo negative merchandising deal. Right.
You might want to be a part of this too, man.
What's bananas?
How are you?
Isn't this something out of a movie?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the hills have eyes.
So we get toothpicks for his eyelids too?
This is going to roll during the credits, Felix.
Yeah, take that to his head. Looks like the,
so who's all witnessing this?
The monkey
friend?
Guy? Come on, take that to his head.
You're doing well.
Wait an hour. Let's see how he's doing now.
Let's move him out to his fire escape.
Okay.
Watch the cop. Don't let him hit his... Come on, do the
camera
thing.
Okay, that one more time.
This, peek in there, see him.
Okay.
Come back out, that kind of thing.
Roll.
That one more time.
You ready?
I am a kind, wonderful human being, sees the value in all life, lover of all living things, typical Christian, hypocristian, yeah.
I think it's a very selfish thing to mourn and to cry and carry on, but I'm a selfish person, so that's why I do it.
My definition of a hypocrite is the person I see in the mirror constantly, who doesn't like me and who I don't like in return. My name is Peter Steele, and I do nothing. I am very happy.
Why?
Because I know someday I will die. We had a really great time. We stayed in the most expensive hotels every night with swimming pools. We had all these Swiss women coming up and giving us these great massages with heated olive oil and mozzarella cheese. Now, this is what Europe sounded like, by the way. It was fantastic. It was asphalt and accents. I'm just your average Polak. Black number one is the type of hair dye that Gothic people use, or some people use, to dye their hair black to fit in with that type of image.
Black number one? I'm not too sure. I was never told.
I think it's about the uprising of the black people and how they're going to take over the world, and how Peter will one day come out of the pit in the desert and lead them all to dominate the entire earth.
The message Typo Negative is trying to get across, I don't think any of us are really sure of.
There is nothing there. We live to avoid death. We exist to avoid non-existence.
To hate and to hurt, and to love and to lose.
Die.
Being my descendants are from Sicily, Italy, there is, we have a reputation of being can-sized. People in general, doesn't matter what color you are, but if you're an anus, you're gonna irritate me, and that's when I don't like you.
A complete history of my musical training would be toilet training, learning how to brush my teeth, and seeing a guitar one day and just picking it up.
Kenneth Sean Hickey. Purpose?
I'm not quite sure yet. What is your purpose?
That's
my beer. What are you walking away with my beer for? Give me my beer.
Pardon me, sir, master.
So wait, my jacket, my beer, my cigarettes. Where's the cigarettes? Where's my cigarettes?
Josh Silver. Keyboardist, Typo Negative. Usually it's an accident. I hit a few buttons, whatever comes up, sounds good. Peter says, yeah, I don't think you could do better, so that's about it.
There was one thing you could change about the band. What would it be?
I quit.
In regards to this new release, what was the most difficult problem that you were forced to deal with for the duration of its recording?
I had to be there the whole time.
This is Typo Negative, Brooklyn, New York.
Yo, Brooklyn!
And we'd like to wish you a happy Halloween. Enjoy block number one, because we don't.
Cut!
Can we do one more for the box, like a more straight one?
Christ!
Do I have to pull my pants up?
Ah, this is a good idea. This is us.
This is Peter from Typo Negative. With my friends, Josh, Kenny, and Sal. And we hope you enjoy block number one. Thank you.
Bye.
Hasta la feces.
I could never ever picture myself as a father my whole life. Because I guess I never really liked myself that much, but I was terrified when I found out she was coming along. But I soon found out She was the easiest thing I've ever loved in my life.
Come on, Mom. Come on, Mom.
And she's made me complete. She's gonna take a nap.
Well, Ma.
That's great.
It's any wonder why autumn is the most favorite season of just about everyone. But the trees are aflame and the water still. It is by far my favorite season. This is probably the perfect location, as you see here, for me to build my dream house, like a Frank Lloyd Wright type of falling water house in a location like this, but a lot more glass. And every morning when I wake up, I have the woods to one side and water to the other, the sky above. And it would always seem like I was outside and I could enjoy nature and all the seasons. So perhaps take a few trees down here, very few trees, build a nice little house for my woman and worship her the rest of my life.
Black number one is the type of hair dye that gothic people use, or some people use, to dye their hair black to fit in with that type of image.
Black number one? I'm not too sure. I was never told.
I think it's about the uprising of the black people and how they're going to take over the world, and how Peter will one day come out of the pit in the desert and lead them all to dominate the entire earth.
The message typo negative is trying to get across, I don't think any of us are really sure of.
There is nothing there. We live to avoid death. We exist to avoid non-existence.
To hate and to hurt and to love and to lose.
Die.
Being my descendants are from Sicily, Italy, we have a reputation of being can-sized. People in general, doesn't matter what color you are, but if you're an anus, you're gonna irritate me, and that's when I don't like you.
A complete history of my musical training would be toilet training, learning how to brush my teeth, and seeing a guitar one day and just picking it up.
Kenneth Sean Hickey.
Purpose? Not quite sure yet. What is your purpose?
The drummer and my
own. It's my beer.
What are you walking away with my beer for? Give me my beer.
Pardon me, sir, master.
It's where my jacket might be, and my cigarettes. Where's the cigarettes? Where's my cigarettes?
Josh Silver. Keyboardist, typo negative. Usually it's an accident. I hit a few buttons, whatever comes up, sounds good. Peter says, yeah, I don't think you could do better, so that's about it.
There was one thing you could change about the band. What would it be?
I quit.
In regards to this new release, what was the most difficult problem that you were forced to deal with for the duration of its recording?
I had to be there the whole time.
This is typo negative, Brooklyn, New York. Yo, Brooklyn! And we'd like to wish you a happy holiday.
This is Megan Glenn Hickey, and she was born to me on January 6th, 1997. She's brand new, fresh melon. She was most unexpectedly conceived, what was it, 19 months ago, on the last night that I was home for a four-month tour. And she was the most incredible surprise that's ever come into my life. She is my reason for waking up every day. She takes three or four steps now to me, and she loves remotes. Favorite toy in the whole world. In fact, the most interesting thing she's ever done was we left her with a grandmother.
Typo negative will be coming to Europe, probably, assuming the flight actually makes it out of the airport. And there's no missile launches or anything pointed at it, and we hope to see you there, and we're going to be supporting October Rust.
You can say that again. What? We could be supporting October Rust.
Anyway, yeah, we'll be in Europe, and
October Rust. October Rust. It's the name of the new typo negative LP. Be my druidess.
Yo, Phil, fuck you,
I
too,
I love
man.
It, goddammit! Why am I yo, man? Be my druidess and Bacchus and what, fourth?
Talking about the songs. It's the ladies that love it, goddammit.
Are you a lady?
No, but I love it too, though. Check it out.
I love you too, Phil.
I love you too, man.
Thank you.
See that? Everything is wonderful.
Hey, I think you need more kick drum before anything else.
Negative will be coming to Europe, probably, assuming the flight actually makes it out of the airport, and there's no missile launches or anything pointed at it, and we hope to see you there, and we're going to be supporting October Rust.
You can say that again.
What? We could be supporting October Rust.
Anyway, yeah, we'll be in Europe, and...
October Rust. October Rust. It's the name of the new Typo Negative LP. Be my druidess.
Yo, Phil, fuck you too.
I love
man.
It, goddammit. Why yo, am I yo man? Be my druidess and Bacchus and what forth? Talking about the songs. It's the ladies that love it, goddammit.
Are you a lady?
No, but I love it too, though. Check it out.
I love you too, Phil.
I love you too, man. Thank you. See that? Everything is wonderful.
Hey, I think you need more kick drum before anything else.
This is Megan Glenn Hickey, and she was born to me on January 6th, 1997. She's brand new, fresh melon. She was most unexpectedly conceived, what was it, 19 months ago, on the last night that I was home for a four-month tour. And she was the most incredible surprise that's ever come into my life. She is my reason.
He said,
donut.
He said, Onku Kantu Kong. He did. And every one of Kong's footsteps, you hear the floor drums.
Typo Negative will be coming to Europe, probably, assuming the flight actually makes it out of the airport. And there's no missile launches or anything pointed at it. And we hope to see you there, and we're going to be supporting October Rust.
You can say that again. We could be supporting October Rust.
Anyway, we'll be in Europe.
October Rust. October Rust. It's the name of the new Typo Negative LP. Be my druidess.
Yo, Phil, fuck you
too,
man.
I love it, goddammit. Why am I yelling at? Be my druidess and Bacchus and what forth?
I'm the vice president.
No, wait. That's uncomfortable.
Of Blue Grape Merchandising. This is how we renegotiate the Typo Negative merchandising deal.
Right.
You might want to be a part of this too, man.
What's bananas?
How are you?
Isn't this something out of a movie?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the hills have eyes.
So we get toothpicks for his eyelids too?
This is going to roll during the credits, Felix.
Yeah, take that to his head. Looks like the,
so who's all witnessing this?
The monkey
friend?
Guy? Come on, take that to his head.
You're doing well.
Wait an hour. Let's see how I was doing an hour.
Let's move him out to this fire escape.
Okay.
Watch the cop. Don't let him hit his...
Bye, Felix. Bye, Felix.
I saw him, man.
Don't break the cop.
Cop.
Get a peek down there.
All right. See you later, man.
Now we should go downstairs and throw shit at him. Come on, bring the cameras down.
Okay, that one more time. Maybe this, peek in there, see him, okay. Come back out, that kind of thing.
Really?
That one more time.
You ready?
Go there. There.